you got some tires. You flip them indoors.
We flip them. We hit them. Jump into. Jump out of. Jump onto. The smaller ones there, we throw around. Stick weights in them. Drag them around as well. So we've got a healthy collection of bumpers and plates, bars, medicine balls. You can see in the corner. Crash mat. We stick it out. Typically, when we have the kids in here for the family workouts, we'll bring the crash mat out. Kids love climbing the ropes. They're usually up there before we figure out what's happening.
Right.
Parallettes. We've got three pairs over there in the corner. Not as long as they should be. And didn't pay quite enough attention to the specs. They're 12 inches. The main handle part as opposed to 24. They still work. They're just not as comfortable to get into. But we're going to be looking at adding more of those as well. That is a homemade agility ladder. It's one of the new pieces of equipment we've got on the way is a proper professional agility ladder coming in. Couple that with some of the cones and dots we have as well for some agility warm-up work that we do. Not thrown into the actual workout itself, but supplemental drills and skills work.
Okay, we're on the third floor here. Do you guys do runs? Do you go outside?
We have two options for doing runs. We either do short little suicides in here. It's about 15 meters end to end in the room, so we can get some runs done. Otherwise, we'll go outside for some of the sprints. One of the downsides, though, is we can't do things like a Helen,
right?
Where we're looking for a 400 meter run plus some pull-ups. So any running workout where we go outside, we can't do the pull-ups with. We drag as much portable gear as we can. Typically, it's dumbbells, kettlebells, or medicine balls. Occasionally, we'll bring a vest or a bungee cord or something like that for a little bit of added resistance training. But yeah, typically it's small tools and body weight movements.
Right.
Coming up actually later on today, we're going to be replacing our current monkey bar set. Over here is version 1, and version 2 should be in by the end of day today. We got this one installed maybe 2 or 3 months into our move here. Dimensions are 12 foot long, 3 foot deep, 8 foot tall. The new one, new set, are going to be 20 feet long, 5 feet wide, and 8.5 feet tall. So we should have at least double capacity on it. I figure we can get at least a dozen to maybe 16 people on there at one time, depending on what they're doing. I didn't look well enough at some of the other existing monkey bar setups when we were planning these ones out. So some of the bars are a little too thick, some are too thin, and the base isn't wide enough in the feet. The plates themselves are not large enough to steady it. So it moves around quite a lot. It really takes away from what we're able to do with them right now. We're either gonna trash them or recycle them, turn them into shelves. We might be able to cut down some of them, shrink the legs a little bit, make some pull-up bars for the kids.
Okay.
Not that to stop them from climbing up 8 feet anyway, but we'll recycle what we can, but we're starting brand new for the version 2 monkey bars. We plagiarized plans from the Brand X folks.
Okay.
And sent them over to our metal worker, and so she's doing them up based on that. We altered things a little bit to keep a similar design in terms of height and typical measurements or standard measurements for bar sizes, so on and so forth. We like I said, we stole directly from Brand X. Those were the first set of monkey bars I jumped onto. That's where I went to for my cert. I loved them. So this is where we tried to model the first set after, and again, learning from what didn't work out quite so well, we got the version 2 underway. We're continually adding new equipment. We just got a few new squat racks in. We've got a bunch more gear on order. That should be coming in the next 2 to 4 weeks. And have a few more things planned that we want to get in very shortly as well.